What's up, everyone? Thunder Trucker here. Today, we're talking about the RTX 2060.
The RTX 2060, NVIDIA's entry-level RTX GPU. This particular model is MSI's 2060 Ventus OC 6GB. It features the same GPU as its big sister, the RTX 2070, TRX's very own TU106. This chip has 1920 CUDA cores, 240 Tensor cores, and 30 RT cores for the sweet and glorious ray tracing. All these little guys are clocked at 1370MHz with a boost clock of 1710MHz. The card itself has one HDMI out and three display ports, so DVR users, well, this isn't the card for you. We also have one 8-pin power connector, so compared to the 2x6-pin of my GTX 660 Ti, this is quite a big deal in terms of power consumption. It is 226mm long, 128mm tall, and 41mm thick, making it shorter than the above mentioned GPU, meaning you can fit it in pretty much any standard case you want. As I said, this GPU is replacing my GTX 660 Ti, and it is going to be tested in my personal rig. The specs are as follows. We have an Intel Core i7-3770K paired with an ASUS P8Z77V Pro motherboard and 16GB of Corsair DDR3 RAM. We have a 500GB boot SSD and a 1TB hard drive, as well as a Corsair AX760 power supply. But enough talk, let's play some games and see some FPS, shall we? First up is Just Cause 4. Now this game wouldn't run on my 660 Ti, whereas with this, the game is happily playing at 1080p 60fps on max settings, and it seems the game is locked to that specific figure. In-game experience was very good, no stutters or anything, just a pleasant game time in all smooth 1080p. Up next is Dirt Rally 2.0. Now I'm a huge racing fan, so I thought I'd try some games related to that. Again, the game seems locked to 60fps, but the GPU was constantly hitting that mark. Again, with max settings, no slowdowns, no stutters, nothing. The game was running with the 660, I just had to lower the settings to a mix between low and medium. Then we have GTA 5. I had an overall bump in game quality. I couldn't quite max out the game because I only have 6GB of VRAM, and God knows, GTA 5 is a big VRAM gobbling monster. But for the love of me, I cannot make it run at more than 30fps. It isn't a big problem in itself because I'm not using a 144Hz panel, but I was hoping to get a bit more performance out of it. I think the GPU is bottlenecked by my processor because there's quite a lot of processing to do. I may have to run more tests once I upgrade my CPU. Up next is F1 2018, and maxed out, the game is not a problem at all for the RTX 2060, with a solid 60fps in the in-game benchmark. However, while doing some in-game testing, I noticed some screen freezes, but it is a known issue in this game, and it's only on 2 or 3 tracks. Finally, I decided to fire up The Division 2 to test a very recent game. I can't show you any FPS readings, however, because MSI Afterburner isn't working with this game for some reason, and there are no in-game benchmarks, so I have to take my word for it. But I can safely tell you that the game runs super smooth on max settings without any issues, which seems to be a recurring thing in this test. And I was hoping no less for this GPU, as it is not cheap, especially for the French market, and my wallet, unfortunately. So that's it for me. Hope you enjoyed this little video. This is my first ever review, so please be gentle. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like and a comment saying what you did like, and if you didn't, please do tell me what you didn't like about this video. I wish you all a very nice day, stay safe, and keep on drifting. See ya.